Good afternoon or good evening to those of you in India. Good morning, good early morning for those of you in the United States. And I think we have people who are coming here from around the world. So this is really cool. I'm Mitch Weisberg. I'm generally the host of EdChat Interactive. My job is easy because we have such incredible people who are doing the presentation. Let me just go a little bit about EdChat Interactive and share my screen for a second. And today we're going to be learning about unleashing student motivation and creativity. And the tool that you're going to be using to do that is Buncee. And the two educators who are going to be leading the session are Shalini Chauhan and Sumedha Sodhi. And, you know, like we all get into teaching because we love seeing kids progress, and some people figure out and do the real work to figure out what is it that makes kids tick and what really excites them. And I have to say, in working with Shalini and Sumedha, I found two people who are the ultimate professionals in this fashion. They obviously work hard at their craft. They've learned a lot of technology tools, but a lot of teaching tools also to really ignite kids and make them really want to learn. And today they're gonna be sharing some of their tips. And in those tips, we're gonna be using Buncee, which really is a phenomenal program and allows kids to express themselves. I do wanna say that we have some other events coming up which are also going to be very interesting. We have, let's see if we can go here. Okay, we have Anupam Sharma and Dr. Vijay Chandrasekaran and Makival Mathusema from Canada, who will be coming next Friday, this coming Friday, to talk about introducing entrepreneurship to students. That's another really interesting topic, because when kids view themselves as entrepreneurs, they really extend themselves in order to make things happen. So that's going to be a really interesting session. And then today, actually attending is Deepti Chopra. And she's going to be doing the second half of her session, showcasing student work with ArtSteps. And that's going to be on February 27th. And then for those of you who are thinking about going international, we're going to be having a session, Building International Revenue Using Serious Games. And we're going to be having George DeBakey, who's going to be talking there. And then we have actually two or three more sessions that are coming up in March and April that I'm going to be putting up later. So all of these will be available on EdChat Interactive. They're always free. And hopefully you find them very interesting. But today I'm going to hand this over right now to Shalini and Sumedha, because you've heard from me enough. So I'm going to stop sharing. And Shalini and Sumedha, welcome to EdChat Interactive. Shalini, you've been on here before, but Sumedha, it's an honor to have you here. So thank you. Thank you both.
Thank you so much for a hearty welcome. So let me share my screen. Is my screen visible? Is it good to go?
It's good to go.
Okay, great. So welcome, dear audience. Good morning, good evening from wherever you are joining. We are so excited to have you all amongst us. And today, me and my friend Shalini, both of us are Buncee ambassador. We are going to talk about that, how Buncee is a tool which is going to empower your hybrid learning. And it is a tool which will fill your classroom with creativity. So if you are looking for unleashing your classroom with creativity and you want to rock your hybrid learning classroom, then Buncee is a great tool. And today we are going to talk about this tool. What are the endless possibilities you can come up with Buncee? So here I am, Sumedha Sodhi, and my friend Shalini. Both of us are Buncee ambassador. We can say we are proud Buncee ambassador. So although we use a lot of tech tools, here you can see my friend Shalini, she is ambassador to so many edtech tools. 3D Bear is her favorite get-to-go tool, Flipgrid, Nearpod, Adobe, but Buncee is something which is very close to our heart. Both of us have been a long time friends, and whatever discussions we have, Bansi is a great tool for both of us. Here I am, Sumedha Sodhi. I also love tech tools, passionate about technology in the classroom, but definitely we are going to share our experience about how Bansi is making our classroom experiences really unique. So over to my friend Shalini to take the lead now.
Thank you, Sumedha. And thank you, Mr. Umesh, for this lovely introduction and providing us this platform to share our learning with other educators. Friends, today we are going to explore a web-based tool for creating interactive multimedia presentations, Bansi. During today's session, we will learn about Bansi, its features, about Idea Labs, where you will find ideas of different educators who have already created lesson plans or Bansis, and how you can enhance students' engagement with the help of this platform. We will be going to share this. So next slide, please. So what is Bansi? First of all, we'll just talk about what is Bansi, a creation and communication tool for students, educators, and administrators to create interactive content, allowing those of all ages of visualizing concepts and communicate creativity. You can create presentations, assignments, worksheets, which are creative and really liked by students. So why should we use Bansi? As Sumedha mentioned that it is one of our favorite tools. Why it is our favorite tool? Because its interactive drag and drop interface helps students, educators, and administrators create engaging multimedia projects and presentations to increase interactive and flip of the classroom. It also helps to empower students as content producers. Students also can give their responses, can add their responses in Bansi boards when you will be sharing the code with them, and they can be the content producers with you, as if you are playing a role of educator, and you can invite your students so they can also add their responses in their Bansis. It also encourages creativity of the students, or as well as for educators also. With a wide array of graphics and intuitive media tools, students can explore their creativity while having fun. And it also assess students' knowledge acquisitions also. And you can easily create, express, and share your ideas through Bansi. You can use Bansi to creative digital storytelling. You can use it to make blended learning book projects. You can create invitations and cards. You can create language learning activities. So I'll take you all these examples during my demo session. And you also can share your lesson plans. You can also share your notebooks. If your students are taking note of any subject, they can also share their notes through Bansi. So the users can integrate content from both external and internal sources, as well as create content directly on each slide. A toolbar provides ease of accessibility and preview without the user ever navigating away from the slide. Bansi is available on a freemium model. So this is the new integration opens Sumedha, last slide please, the previous one. This new integration opens the door for many new learning opportunities and can be an integral tool for your virtual classroom, professional development, and beyond. So if you are using MS Teams, you can directly invite your students through this Bansi. You need not to go to MS Teams to create any meeting or invite your students. Next slide, please. Now students and educators can unlock badges for completing various tasks. You and your students will be rewarded with badges as you create Bansi, you complete assignments, or engage on Bansi's boards and more. Work your way from Bansi's explorer or to Bansi's grandmaster. So educators and students can find their badges on their profile page. Educator can also view their students' Bansi badges in their classes. I will show how to view and share your badges during my demo session. So please allow me to take you to the platform.
You know, while you're doing that, one of the things that I'm noticing is that these slides are really so much more interactive than the slides that people generally use using Google Slides or PowerPoint. And you did these slides in Bansi also, right? So it just really gives, it's not just for the student creation, but it gives the teachers a great tool as well, right?
Thank you. So I would request everybody to join me in this demo session. Please type in bansi.com in your web browser. Once you will, I'll just show you when you will type in bansi.com. So this link will take you to this interface where it's uploading. So you will see this interface because I have already account on Bansi. If you don't have account, you have to create it. So let me show you how you can create your account on Bansi. First, I need to log out from my account. So I request everybody to just join me to have some hands-on experiences. Bansi.com. Now you will be taken to this interface. Here you can see login or sign up. So if you don't have any account on Bansi, you have to sign up. As I have already account, so I am logging in. Here you can see, hope my screen is visible. Here you can see this discover. Here you can find what is Bansi. You can request for a demo. You can request for pricing. You can request to know about their programs. And here you get inspired. If you are new to this platform, this amazing platform, you can go for PD or training sessions by clicking on it, and you will have all the sessions which are already recorded, or you can also get the notification of live sessions which Bansi, the people behind this platform are taking live sessions on a regular basis. So you can see there are many videos already here, how to navigate the classroom dashboard, how to log in as a student, or how to earn your badges, or how to make new Bansi. So this way you can do all these training sessions. And here is the Idea Lab. This is amazing part of this Bansi because this is a library where you can find the already the educators around the world. They have already created fabulous Bansis of different on different subjects or different topics. You can just take the idea from there. You can copy that. You can use it. If you want to edit it, it's your wish. But you can use as it is also. So let's move to this platform. First, I am clicking on login. Please follow the step so that you can come to know how to create your account. Now it will ask you on which ID you want to create an account. You can create your account on Google or Microsoft or Apple, or you can even use your own ID. So I have already created on Google. So I'm clicking on sign in with Google. Now it will ask you which ID you would prefer to go to this Bansi platform. So I'm clicking on my preferred ID. And let's see what happens. So once you click on your ID, your which you prefer to go to Bansi platform, then it will take you to your homepage dashboard of your own presentations. I would mention here that we call our presentation Bansi form, so we don't have it created. So let's see. But
I think there is some problem with Shalini's connection. She is not audible.
Create your worksheets also. You can invite your students to do some activities or some assignments or classes. You can even...
Yes, there does seem to be an issue with Shalini's.
I'm not Shalini's. Audible.
Yeah, Shalini.
Oh, now you
I
are.
Am I audible?
Yeah, now you are audible, but previously you were not. I think there was some glitch in your audio.
Okay.
And even I am not able to see your screen. I think she is logged out, so let her join back. Let me carry forward the session. So I'm going to share my screen and take you to the Bansi platform by the time she's joining. Is it visible?
Yes.
Okay. So first we will talk about that how to create a new Bansi presentation. So just now Shalini has told you that by using your Gmail account or using your Microsoft ID, you can log in into your dashboard. And as you log in into your dashboard, you see this plus button where I just click create new. And Bansi gives you a lot of platform to choose the templates, which you can pick up. Like there are templates for awards and recognition. There are templates for birthday greetings, back to school. There are templates for bookmarks, brochure, business card templates you can design. You don't have to spend money on getting your business card made by professionals. Bansi gives you a template to create your own business card. And for educator, it is such a wonderful platform that you have so many ready to use worksheets that you can engage children in classroom. You have worksheets for arts and music. You have worksheets for English. You have worksheets for interdisciplinary activities, language learning, library, maths, and so on. I think if I'm not wrong, there are over 35,000 templates which you can pick up and create your presentation. So let us, yeah, Shalini, are you back?
Yeah. Thank you, Sumedha. Thank you for taking over the session.
Yeah.
So can I share my screen?
Yeah, sure, definitely.
Thank you so much.
I may need to make you co-host again.
Is my screen visible?
It's starting to. Yes.
Thank you. Thank you, Sumedha, once again. So I hope you have started sharing, you know. So should I start?
You can start. From creating a new Bansi.
Okay, fine. So friends, first of all, I will take you to the left panel. This is written classes here. So here you can create your own classes and you can invite your students to be a part of your presentation or you can invite your students to be the part of your assignments and they can collaborate with you during your classroom. This is Bansi, where you can see your all presentations, your all Bansis, as you can see my Bansis here. And next is boards, where you can create board and you can invite educators or students around the globe. And this will be taken by my friend Sumedha. And this is the part shared with me here. Whatever boards are shared with me, you can see in this part. Next is the MS Team, which I have already explained that here MS Teams, you can create your meetings directly from here. And this is Idea Lab, which is the fantastic part of this Bansi platform, where you can have multiple ideas and you can create your own Bansis with the help of these ideas. You need not to create on your own. So here, if you want to find some particular topic or some subject, you can type in and you can find millions of ideas over here and you can select from there. So I'll take this part later during creating my Bansi. See how many worksheets are there on maths only, and you can find other worksheets also on other subjects. Now this is create. Here you can create your Bansi in two ways. You can click here, click create. There are two versions, version 3.0 or 2.0. Nowadays, educators are using version 3.0. And even you can click on this plus button and you can create your Bansi. After that, you can see this bell button where you can get the notification. Whenever you create any Bansi, you will get a badge from Bansi people behind this platform, and you can get the notification. This is your profile, from where you can find your, you can view your profile, you can view your rewards, you can do, you can go directly to Idea Labs, you can go to Clips, and you can log out or log in. So let's create our Bansi. So I am clicking here on version 3.0. Let's see. So this interface will come after clicking on create a Bansi. So you can see, you can type in here and find multiple ideas on different themes. You can create your business cards, you can create your brochures, you can create bookmarks, you can create birthday greetings, or even you can find the worksheets on different topics, different subjects. You can create your newsletters, posters, anything you want, you can create on Bansi. And one way you can type in here, and the other way you can click on this plus button. Again, you will get the three options. First option is click here to select a template, which I just showed you. And let's see what happens when we click on this. The same interface has come on our screen. So you can select from here. So let's create one Bansi on mathematics. I want to create a worksheet for my students and I want to invite them for doing that worksheet. So let's take this snowball simplest form challenge. So once I click on that worksheet, it will come on your screen and then you can click on use this template. You can see here, if you don't like this, when you view this and you don't like this, you can go to back. You can click on back. So this Bansi is created here. And now this is the question. These are the questions which you want your students should do. And this is a challenge. Once you have make them understood the topic simplest form in fractions, and now you want to check their learning. So you can create this interactive worksheet. Now, after that, I want to create other slide in my presentation. So whenever you want to add page, you have to go to this left panel and click on plus sign. And you will have two options again. First is blank new page, or you want to stitch. This I will cover later, how you can stitch your Bansi. If suppose you have created many Bansis and you want to repeat any of the slide in other part. If you have created one assignment for class 7 and you want that concept should be revisited by the stage 8 student or stage 9 student. So you can just take that clip from your previous presentation and you can add in your new presentation. This is the another part. I will take it later. Let's move to blank new page. When I click on add blank new page, again you will get three options. Now I will take you to the other feature of this wonderful platform, that is click here to change background. And the third one is click here to add your first item. Whenever you want to add item, you need to go to this right hand side panel, and here you can see items are written. Once you click on plus sign, you will get many items to add in your Bansi presentation. First, let's learn how to change our background. So here you can see, you can take the background from web. You can change the color of your background. You can choose any color. You can upload it. You can use trending. You can use recently used with whatever background you have used in your previous slides or presentations. You can use that again. Newly added Bansi challenges. Then you can take about me, animals, art, birthdays, Bansi cards, business cards, sorry, cards or comic strips or designs, education. So let's take education and let's find which background we want to take. So let's take this one. So once you click on your selected item, you can see here, add to this page or all pages. If you have selected a background, you can make it the same on all the pages during your, throughout your presentation, or you can use a different background for different pages. So let's take it for this page only. After that, once our background is set, now we have to add items. Now, how can we add items? I told you, you have to come to this right side panel and you have to click on plus. Once you click on plus, this magic box will come up and you have multiple items here to add in your Bansi. Let's start with text. If I click on text, you can write anything on your double click. First, you have to double click and you can write anything in this text box. So let's take fraction. Now, if you want to adjust this text, you can change the font of this text. You can make it according to your choice. You can choose any of the text which you like to be on your presentation. You can increase the size, font size. You can underline it, you can make it italic, whatever the features we can use in arranging our text, all are available here. So next is shapes. If you want to add any shape, these shapes will be here. So you can select any 3D shape and here you can select multiple items together. Suppose I have selected 3D shape, sparkle. So you can see here number will get increased. Add two, add three, add four. How many items will you will select? The number will get increased and all these items will come on your Bansi, the selected one. Let's take two for now. So you can see two items are already on my presentation. Now next is drawing. So this is very good feature for small kids. If you want to draw something, you can draw. Your kids want to draw something, they can also draw. Like, sorry for bad drawing, but you can do anything with this feature. You can draw it. Now next is 3D, Bansi 3D. So here, this is my favorite one. You can select any 3D figure from here. Let's take this shape. Okay, So I have added three items. I'm just showing you how you can select your items and how you can make it come on your slide. Now next is animation, Bansi animation. Here you will have multiple items to add in your Bansi to make it interactive and interesting. So here we can select this one. Here also you can select multiple items, all will come on your Bansi. So this way we have just covered only five items. So same way you can take Bansi stickers, Bansi messages, and you can add and make your presentation interactive and interesting. Even you can make your presentation for your sessions also, as I do. Mostly I use Bansi platform to create my presentation. Whenever I present on any platform, I prefer to use Bansi because it's really amazing. I'll show you when I will see, I will show you the preview, then you will get to know how it works. So let's add one more slide. Now again, I have to take blank page. Now I have to take one background. Let's take plain background this time. And how to add? You can add web images also. You can search from web and you can add any image here. Let's take any toy. You can also add, you can drag it according to your convenience. You can add 360 image. Here, you can show the students 360 image and virtual visit. They can go for virtual trip by using this. Let's take this one. I will show how it works in preview. Just now, I am creating my Bansi. Have you seen? I am just adding my items to my Bansi and I am creating different slides. And you can also take YouTube channel link. You can upload. Now I will show you this on next slide, how you can upload videos or photographs. So here, if I have clicked on upload, let's see. Here you will get three things, my images, my documents, and my videos. So for this feature, you should have your videos in your Bansi already. So let's take this one. You can again choose.
Hello everyone, I'm Akant Jain.
Let's take this one and I will show how it works. In this way, you can add videos and photographs and you can make your Bansi presentation amazing. Let's take one photograph. So now, you can record your video, you can record any video message for you. Your students, you can take your photograph, you can add your photograph in your Bansi presentation. And these two are very amazing features. Once you want to create any quiz or worksheet for your students, this is the feature. Free response question. So what? So you can write types of fractions. Types of fraction. Let's see. This is free response question. Your child can write the answer in this question. And this is multiple choice question. Here you can create multiple choice question for your students. suppose you want to delete this, you don't want to be to put this part in your on your this slide, so you can just click and you can click on backspace and you can delete this item from your presentation, from your slide. Now again, I am adding. You can create any multiple choice question here. You can write here. You can write the answer. Improper fraction can be converted into mixed fraction. So your options are yes or no. Your child will just click. You have added, save it, and it will come on your slide. So now the time to show you the preview. Once your presentation is done, now you can click on preview.
And I think in this case, you mean mixed fraction, not missed fraction?
I have written missed.
Missed, sorry. Yes.
Sorry. Mixed.
No, that's okay. I just, that's kind of the teacher in me. It just like popped out.
I'll just check it once again. It's mixed fraction, M-I-X-E-D. So it's, you can write it here. Now how your child will do this worksheet. Once you will share, you can see this share tab. You will have to click on this share tab and you can see the setting. You have to make it copyable. When you want to share your presentation, your Bansi with your students, with your educators, you have to make it copyable. And then you have to click on code and you can copy the link and you can share it either by mail or WhatsApp or whatever platform you want to use. The second slide. I will show you how your child can work on this slide also. The second slide is.
And that code that you just copied, you could put into the chat so that we could even try the one you're just creating, right?
Sure. Is my screen visible? So I will show you the 360. Yeah,
screen share has stopped. Shalini, please share it again.
Fine. Is it visible?
Yes. Now it's visible. Thank you.
So see, you can see the 360 view and you can show it to your students in the class. You can select any picture and you can show it. The next slide is when you click on this is the picture. When you click on any picture, it pops up and you can see see the picture on your screen. This is the video.
You care for others, and when you make others feel that there is someone to look out for them, that is kindness. It is a trait only human beings express, and it is the highest trait that human beings can practice. I firmly believe in kindness, and I believe that this act of spreading love and seeing world as an integrated whole can help us survive in the long term. At the end of every month, I distribute porridge to the poor people in temples and my neighboring slum areas, thus combating goal number 2, zero hunger.
So now I have to do the worksheet given by my teacher. So I have to click on edit. Once I will copy it, when I am sharing the link with all of you, you can also do this worksheet. Let me share the link. I can't. Sumedha, I am posting it on your WhatsApp. Please do share in the chat window.
Okay, sure.
So that girl was saying that kindness is exhibited by human beings. Can kindness be exhibited by politicians also?
Okay, I'm just sending it. Hope you have got it.
Yeah, I'm just connecting my laptop. I will just share in 2 minutes.
Now, you can continue. I have to click on edit and I want to do my
worksheet. Yes, Shalini, I don't think we're seeing your screen well. It's not refreshing right now.
Okay. I have to click on edit. Now you can answer.
Oops, and I think we lost her. So,
okay, yeah, I will continue with the next part. No problem. I am going to share my screen. So as Shalini has told you that how you can create your Bansi presentations and using so many powerful templates, you can really make your classroom learning experience, whether it is offline or it is online. Both the experiences can be widened, and I can see it can be glorified if you use Bansi as an edtech tool in your classroom. So I'm going to show you how you can create a Bansi class, and you can invite students into the Bansi platform itself to do the worksheets and assignments rather than you sharing the link of the Bansi presentation. You also have another option where you can invite students to come to the Bansi class. So this option, the first option that you see on the left side panel, that is the classes. Once I reach here, these are some of my existing classes. Let us create a new class. So once I click here on new class, the first box which appears is where I have to write my class name. So maybe let me create a new class for this session. So I say this is a class for EdChat Interactive. Subject is optional. I can leave it. Grade is also optional. If you want to put your subject and grade, you can put it. And once you put all the details, you can simply click on create. And here you see, I have successfully created my class. Now the second step is I have to invite my students with this code. So once I want to invite my students, I will simply tell my students that this is the code you have to use. That is R capital, Y capital, 2 and 5. So where the student is going to enter this code? So if you remember on the first page while logging in, once you log in into bansi.com, the dashboard. So on this screen, since I'm already logged in, I think I have to log out first. So once I log out, I will be able to show you that how you can put the code and you can join the class. So let me just log out from the account.
Or if you want me, since I can log out on my computer, and I can do that if you'd rather.
Yes. So here I have logged out, and before login in, there is another option which is popping up, which is saying create your student account with a class code. So here is the place I have to type that code, which was showing in my Bansi class. So if you want to try it right now, you can try putting that code and just see if you are able to see my class. I'm not sure you will be able to log in into my class because I have a limited number of students that can be added into my class, into my Bansi account, but you can definitely try it. But this is the proper way, the technique that you have to follow to invite your students into your class. And once your students are in your class, they will also see the same dashboard. They just have to go to the class option and they will be already added into the class. Once they open the class, let me show you. This is my Bansi class. So these are names of my students, which are flashing here, their first name, their last name. And these are some of the Bansi submissions that they have done, and they have earned badges. So these are the badges that you see, which are earned by the students by making Bansi presentations. So let me show you the Bansi presentation, which are made by the students. Some of the assignments which I have shared with them. So you are able to see how my children are able to earn so many badges for them. As a teacher, I can see their badges. I can see their submissions. I can see what Bansis are created by the students, by me, by my students. So everything is available in the dashboard, and you can easily assign the assignments to students. So this is the place you can easily assign the worksheets. The way Shalini has created the assignment, maths assignment, once you go to this tab in the class and you click on add assignment, so it will ask you what is the title you want to give. You can choose the title. You can choose a description for your assignment. You can set the start date, the due date. Who is going to respond to that worksheet? Do you want to assign that worksheet to all the students, or you want to give it to a specific set of students? You can also customize that. Then this is the place you have to add your Bansi. So I have, once I click here, all my Bansi presentations, whichever I have in my dashboard, are going to open over here. So here you can see, I can choose any of my favorite Bansis to be added. Do you want students are required to submit a Bansi presentation for doing that assignment? So you can click yes. If they are not required to make another Bansi and they can make only additions to your assignment, you can simply put it off, and you can simply click here submit. So once you do all these steps, you will be able to create a worksheet for your students inside the Bansi classroom, and you can also share your feedback for students inside the Bansi only. You don't have to refer to the different LMS system or different dashboards to give feedback to students. So that really makes Bansi a very powerful, I can say, edtech tool, which really my children simply enjoy it. And same is the case with Shalini. Now, next important segment here is how you can collaborate with students and educators with the help of Bansi Boards. So Bansi Board is a collaborative space where you can participate with the other educators and other students around the globe who does not belong to your classroom. You can collaborate with them, and you can invite them to share their Bansis on your board. So it works like in the same way like we collaborate on tools like Padlet, or we collaborate on tools like Jamboard, where we can invite others to share their contribution. So let us create a Bansi board right now. So how I create a new Bansi board? So for creating a new Bansi board, I should have some Bansi to use it. So for example, I click here, new Bansi board. So it will ask me that what is the title you want to give to your Bansi. So here I can give any title. So as per the Bansis which I have already created, let me just use one of the previous Bansi presentations. So if I say I want to do something on SDGs, so I will create a Bansi board for sustainable development goals. I can write a description here. So description will mention about kindly share with us the solutions you have for the global challenges. Pick the goal you are passionate about. So I can create this kind of description for the audience to know that what exactly they have to do. And once I'm done with this, I click on this done button. And now is the time to put my contribution first. So as I click on plus button, it will ask me that, do you have a link of any Bansi to be pasted here? Or I can simply choose a Bansi from the list of the dashboard which I already have. So these are the Bansis which I already have. So let me choose a Bansi on SDGs. So here is one Bansi, which is already talking about sustainable development goals, which I have made earlier. So here my Bansi has got added. Now is the time to share this collection with the other educators. So how do I share it so that other people are able to contribute in this? So I have these two settings button over here. First, I will see who can comment on my Bansi. So I can see right now there is no comment, and activity I can check right now. There is no activity because I have not shared it, but this is the code which will help me to share my Bansi. So I can click on the share button. I can share this Bansi board with my friends. I can share this Bansi board on Facebook, integrate into my Google Classroom, my LinkedIn, Pinterest, Twitter. I can simply email it, copy this link and put it, or I can share this Bansi board with my students also into the Bansi Classroom, which I have created, and give some collaborative projects to students. For example, we do projects like goals project, we do projects like climate action project, where a lot of collaboration is required with the classroom. And especially in the digital environment, it was difficult to curate the idea. So Bansi board has come to the rescue of educators and helping them jot down and collaborate ideas with the students. I can also simply copy this code and share it with my friends, my students, and they can go to their board, Bansi board, and put this code over there, and they can simply join my collection. And same way, the other people can also click on plus button, create their own Bansi, mentioning the challenge which I have stated in the description, and add here. So this collection will keep on growing. And so, now let me share this.
Sumedha, it sounds to me then that you've worked with other educators where you've all gotten together and said, we're going to be teaching a unit on so-and-so, let's say sustainable development goals. And then different ones of you will create different Bansis within a Bansi board like this so that you're really sharing the work.
Yeah, definitely. That will be a great idea. So let me put this in chat, the link to this Bansi board, and it will be really great if you all can contribute to this Bansi board. I have put the link of this Bansi board in the chat. I would really like educators here to create their Bansi presentations, mentioning about which SDG goal you are passionate about and what plausible solutions you can suggest to work upon this. That will be our Bansi board, which we can be really proud about, and we can curate more resources here and see that how people are catering to the needs and the global challenges around the world. That really is a very powerful feature which I enjoy with my students. Now, let me take you to the Bansi presentation. Just let me do the login again so that I can share my some of the use cases that how we are using the Bansi with our students. That is really powerful, which will help us to understand that how Bansi can be used in the classroom situation with the students. So as Shalini have given you a few examples related to mathematics classroom, I take social sciences for the high school students. So I would like to show you some of the examples from the social science classroom. Since you know social science is such a subject which revolves around society, so there is so much to do in Bansi, and especially during the pandemic time, my children were so happy to join the Bansi classroom and come and share their experiences, and they created Bansi presentations which were really awesome. Even I was amazed to see that how much of creativity students have incorporated. So once Shalini is back, she will be sharing her use cases, but by the time she's not here, let me show you some of the
activities. I am here, Sumedha.
Okay. So Should we like to continue with your use cases first?
No problem. You first carry on, please.
Okay, sure. Thank you so much. So let me show you
later.
Okay. So here is the first example I would like to share with you, that I was teaching about agriculture to my grade 10 students. And we thought of doing some bansi activity to make it little interactive. So instead of me telling them that this is the crop which grows in a particular season, or this requires this much temperature, which really becomes monotonous, I took this template from Bansi Ideas Lab and I customized it to adjust into my agriculture topic. And we did a virtual Let's Cook Together activity, cooking without fire. So all my students did cooking, and after doing their cooking, they made this bansi presentation. This is not made by me. This is a sample I'm choosing from my student work. I have just stitched it into my bansi presentation to show you. So after doing the project, the child prepared the choco lava cake. Then the child also mentioned that what ingredients the child has taken, what kind of crop it is. Is it a rabi crop? It is a kharif crop? It is a zaid crop? These are different crops, varieties of cropping pattern that we have in India. And then they have also mentioned what type of temperature it requires to grow, what type of soil it requires to grow, how much rainfall it is required for that particular crop to grow. So instead of me coming in the picture as a center, with the bansi, my student came into the center of learning that really helped them to imbibe those concepts in a better way. This is another Ideas Lab template, which I love to use in my classroom to instill the critical thinking skills and problem skill, solving skills in my children. So this is a template which I have simply taken from Ideas Lab, stating what will the world look like in 100 years. So I shared this template. These were the directions for the students to follow. And this is the work created by my student, that what kind of a society the child would be able to see in the future. And not only this, the child was also asked to record his video here. So I would like to play it so that you can see what all the reflections the child has shared for this particular activity.
What will the world look like in 100 years? To start with, how our lives and the world would be like in 100 years. Let's first see how the world has changed from the 1920 to the present 2020. There was no smart technology like phones, laptops in 1920. Nor were there any mode of transportation for longer distance in a short time. People had to travel by boat and complete 1 month voyages to reach the destination. Therefore, I believe by the next 100 years, we would be living in a utopian society, which means a perfect society for work, our world. And this would mean that we would have achieved all the SDGs, if not by 2030, then before 2120. But this can only happen if we all progress together and start helping attainment of SDGs. The world of 2120 will have improved infrastructure and better ways of getting around. We will stabilize at around 11 billion global population, and 90% of the global population will live in cities.
I'm going to stop it.
And will result in complete.
So let's move forward. I just wanted to show you the glimpse of how children were really enjoying it. This is the another sample I would like to put across. This idea also I have taken from Ideas Lab. Ideas Lab is my favorite library, which come to my rescue whenever I want to do something interesting with my students. So in my grade 9, I teach about French Revolution. So reading the history book sometimes becomes very monotonous for students, and they are not very interested in learning about history in a very monotonous way. So I used this template from Ideas Lab, which was on my travel itinerary. So I thought of using this activity to teach about France to my students. So they designed their virtual passports, they designed their boarding pass. The template was already given there. They were just supposed to do some text editing and create their own business class boarding pass. They
also that was researched. So clever. That was so clever that the boarding is after COVID-19. I love that.
Yeah. So they also researched about France and the top tourist attractions in France, because I was teaching them about so many concepts, the Europe, the society in France, about Louis XVI, about the clergy, about the church. But since they are from India, they were not able to relate anything. So I told them to research about France, find out the top tourist attractions in France, and they researched about some of the videos they have also inserted here in the Bansi template. And here they have recreated the scene by using the different images, stickers, and here is the recorded video of the child that what he has learned from this activity. I would like to show this video.
I never visited France before, and while doing this project, I got to know about that. The France is a very romantic country, and it emphasizes on the values like fraternity, equality, and liberty. So what I learned from the chapter French Revolution was that, like in different parts of the world, people are suppressed. They are mentally, physically, and even emotionally harmed. So these people raise their voices and revolt. French society also went under such a big revolt that led to a revolution. So, present-day France is one of the most popular world tourist places.
So the Bansi really helped me to make my social science classroom really interesting. And those of you who know me, many of you are here who already know me, my students love Bansi so much that they tweet every day about their new Bansi, which they are creating. So that's really make Bansi a very powerful tool, because it has helped me to connect with my students better. And especially during the pandemic, if this kind of technology would not have been there, I don't think I would have maintained the same kind of connection with all the stakeholders in the same way, even with parents, because we do virtual assemblies on Bansi, we do birthday celebrations on Bansi, we do classroom presentations on Bansi. So I think Bansi has rightly put its quote as a tool with endless possibilities, and I simply believe in the same. So over to you, Shalini. Now I'm putting your slides to share your use cases. Do you want to share your own screen, or shall I play it for you?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
You can share.
Yes, so you can start now.
So these are the slides which I have created for... Am I audible?
Yeah, yes, you are audible.
Hello?
Yes, Shalini,
so
I can
these
hear
are you. The slides which I have just... okay. So these are the slides which I have just taken from my presentations. I told you about stitch and clip pattern. So Sumedha, would you please pop up some pictures? I have used different platforms to make maps creative and engaging for my students. So I am using Jamboard, a Padlet, or other Wiklet, Flipgrid. Hello? Hello?
Yes, Shalini,
so
you are audible.
Okay. So I'm using this Bansi platform for documenting my work and for app smashing also. This is my Padlet wall where I'm feeling on during their online classes in maths. Can you please play this video, Sumedha? This is my student, one of the students.
Hello,
who
everyone.
Recorded his voice.
I'm
Khan
Jain. And today
so
I'm going to be talking about
Bansi during my one presentation on this summit.
Integers and their uses in our daily lives. What are integers? Integers consist of 0, the positive numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, and the negative numbers minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and so on. So what do we use integers for in our daily lives? We use them to tell AB or BC times. For example, that happened 500 BC years ago. Or in checking the temperatures.
So this is the response.
For example,
I have lots
today
of videos,
is minus
so I just
2
added 1
degrees.
To give the... Hello? Yeah. Thank you, Sumedha. So this was one of the sample from my video, from my student's work. And next slide, please. So I use this platform for documenting my work. This is one of the project which we presented on DSIC Summit for climate action. And Sumedha was also there. Sumedha was also the part of that DSIC Summit. So can you play this video, the down one? Where I just invited my students to share their views on kindness, on Padlet and Mentimeter, and I have just added these all samples in my Bansi platform, my Bansi presentation to showcase their work. So in this way, we can use Bansi form, or you are presenting any presentation. So you can use this. You should go for this platform to create your presentations because it is more interactive. So, Sumedha, can you please play this second video?
Today, I'm going to speak of the topic, kindness matters. For me, kindness does matter. And I think we can achieve all the sustainable development goals through kindness. For me, kindness is the quality of being friendly, generous, and considerate towards life in any shape or form. And us humans have been labeled as social animals. So it's up to us and our little steps that we take towards society to make it a better place for the generations to come as well as for us. For me, I personally do not consume any type of seafood, and I have helped spreading awareness towards saving oceans and marine life. And I think it's a very small step at a very small level, but I believe in the saying that small droplets make the mighty oceans, and I hope I can help make a change in the world to come. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sumedha. Next slide, please. So these are the pictures of Climate Action Project. There on DSIC Summit platform, we reflected, we showed the reflection from different projects, which we did on SDGs or in math class. So I presented this reflection from Climate Action Project 2020. I was the part of that project, and I involved my students also. So this is, please play this video. This is very cute video from a small child.
I'm with my planet. I'm with my planet.
Our planet is getting hotter and hotter. Less of oxygen, less of water. To stop global warming, let's plant a tree. Make Earth a better home for you and me. Thank you.
Please say, Earth for us. Thank you.
Should we do? We should plant more trees. And jitna trees plant karenge, utna hi global warming kam.
God has gifted us beautiful Mother Nature, sun, fresh air, water, and beautiful climate. So we request you to save our environment for future. Thank you.
Always switch off lights before leaving.
We should plant more and more trees.
We can turn off lights, the TV, the computer.
You know, a little hand.
Thank you, Sumedha. Next slide, please. So these are the collaboration which I did with other educators around the globe, and this was I just presented on my one of the session, and this was the clippings from other sessions. So please, next slide, please. Hello.
Yes, Shalini, can you see my screen? It's here.
Yes, Sumedha. This was the climate action. Please click on this picture. It was the collaboration with Elcon International and ZPH School, High School, during our climate action project. So this was, we invited our students to share their learning and their views about climate action project. And we had a great time that during those sessions, isn't it, Sumedha? So next, hello. I don't think am I audible?
Yeah, yes. Yeah, Shalini, absolutely, we can hear you. Continue.
Hello.
Yes, you can continue.
Okay. So this slide is where I collaborated my SDG project. I invited my students to create comic strips on different SDGs as quality education or gender equality. So this was the challenge given by Bansi Ida, and I participated in this Bansi board, and I created these two slides, this one and the next one. Please show the next one, Sumedha. And in this way, you can also collaborate with other educators, or you can just share your views on different topics. So this was my work, and that's it. Over to you, Sumedha.
Thank you, Shalini. That was really powerful. So I think now we are only left with the last slide, where we would like to say that you don't have to be great to start. So don't feel overwhelmed with so many features. But you have to really start to be great. So once you start exploring Bansi, it will help you to understand the platform better. And you will definitely be glad that it will make your classroom filled with new creative expressions. And it will help you to unleash your creativity as well as the creativity of your students. So this was all about our presentation for the day. So over to you. Mr. Michel.
Oh, so it seems to me that you've used Bansi as a way for you to present. You've used Bansi as a way for the kids to create, and then creating using all those higher levels of Bloom's, right? So they're creating, they're analyzing, they're evaluating. And then by using Bansi, they're also presenting to an authentic audience, so it kind of gives them voice and choice, and it makes your the presentations that you do, you can collaborate with other educators to work together on projects. So it's kind of a platform that really not only excites the kids, but also can be used to make your work easier, right? That those seem to be the ways that, as a summary, that you're using Bansi, correct?
Yeah, definitely. You got it absolutely right.
And I guess you use primarily the classroom plan. Oh, sorry, Shalini. Yes, go ahead.
No, it's okay. You continue, please.
Oh, no. So you primarily use the classroom plan, correct?
I just want to say all my friends that please start using Bansi and start creating your presentations, involving your students, because it's really amazing platform. And during my earlier stages, I found it little difficult. How should I start with Bansi? Because I teach small younger students. I don't have higher classes, so I just wanted to explore how should I involve my students. So I found that I can create small worksheets, or I can create some activities with them, and I can invite them to be a part of Bansi. And really, it is very helpful, and I would recommend all of you to just start exploring this platform and just start using this platform. Thank you so much.
And I want to make sure that Meenakshi, that your question was answered, or if not, maybe you can unmute yourself and ask your question out loud.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am, Sumedha ma'am, Shalini ma'am, and thank you, sir. Actually, I got the answer for whatever there was in my mind. Thank you so much, and I'll go for that classroom subscription for 150 students. I guess that'll be fine. Thank you.
Oh, okay, good. Okay, I'm glad your question was answered. So, before we just completely log off, Sumedha and Shalini, can each of you? Maybe one thing that you'd like to say to educators around the world?
Yeah, one thing I would like to say here is, first of all, thank you so much that you have taken out your precious time, especially on weekend. Generally, educators like to relax on weekend, but you are those bunch of educators who have decided to learn something rather than relaxing. So that really itself is a testimony of your hard work and your dedication towards making learning a unique experience. So these EdTech tools are not only the way to become more overwhelmed and do professional development, but as an educator for over 13 years, I think this was the first year when I really enjoyed that I should not miss my class. So every day I used to create such unique experiences that not a single child used to miss the virtual class, while other educators who were teaching in a traditional mode, so they face the challenges that even though we are doing the hard work, but children are not joining the remote learning classes. So these are the techniques in which we can make the learning go ahead. And not only we can educate, but we can create a force of lifelong learners by making learning fun and engaging for all of them. And since tomorrow is a Valentine's Day, so I would like to express my love for Bansi. And Bansi team is also here with us. It's really glad that they have connected us just to see me and Shalini, since we are the Bansi ambassador and they are here to express our love for us. So I'm really glad. And I thank you from the bottom of my heart to Bansi team to give such a powerful technology in our hands. Thank you.
And Shalini, do you have a comment?
Yeah, sure. I just want to tell everyone that please be open to learning and always try to be a better version of yourself every new morning. Because if you are open to learning, you definitely will learn new things. You definitely will explore new things and you definitely will create a history and you motivate your students because they really look up to you.
And for me, since tomorrow is Valentine's Day, I just want to remind you all that's the day that wives buy their husbands really great gifts. So be sure to buy your husband, if you're female, be sure to buy your husband a great gift. And if you're male, be sure to say thank you for the great gift that you receive. So
I have created a Bansi card for my husband.
Oh.
Valentine's Day. I think Meenakshi has
very nice, Sumedha.
She has raised hand. So Meenakshi ma'am, you have any question?
Yes. No, I just want to ask one thing. Like if I go for this individual subscription, I don't go for that, school and principal one, and I have got 150 students, okay, and of different classes, will I be able to add in different classes and I will be able to interact with them, is it? And I guess if I want to make something as a principal, I want to guide my teachers, or maybe I have something interactive with them. Can I add my teachers as students over there? Is it
yes?
So?
You can create a class and you can add anyone. You just have to share a code, whether they are your teachers or they are principals or they are students. It is just one place you are collaborating with them.
Yeah, I will bring this kind of innovation in the coming session in my school 21-22. And this is really very nice. I also do love this Bansi. Wonderful.
Thank you both so much.
You have explained everything in detail. And you are the one who has brought me to these various digital tools. It's just wonderful.
Thank you, ma'am. Coming from a school principal, it really means a lot. You are a school principal, and when you speak such words, it really gives us a lot of motivation and inspiration. Thank you so much, Meenakshi ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, Meenakshi ma'am. Thank you so much.
Well, and thank you to all of you who gave up a portion of your weekend, your Saturday, to be with us. I hope to see you at future events, and especially thank you to Sumedha and Shalini for coming on EdChat Interactive. See you all soon and have a great rest of the weekend. Take care. Bye.
Thank you. Bye, everyone.